Are you struggling with lack of time for your artwork because you are working, you are having the kids, or you're having other family related issues, or you're a student or whatever? Are you facing that problem of time for your art? Don't you have the enough time for your art? Then this place is right for you. Keep watching this video till the end. Hey guys, welcome back. I'm Pashvika. Today I'm going to talk about how to do the time management for your art, because you are wasting your time on the things that really doesn't matter to you, or you don't have the time, enough time for your art. So let's start with this video. So beginning with first approach that I have for you is priorities. You need to write on a piece of paper what are your priorities. It can be depending on your day, or it can be depending on your week or month or whatever. Just need to write out. Suppose you're writing for one day and you can think, what are the priorities, or what are the things that are really important for me to do in this day? And then you're gonna dedicate each particular time, amount of time for that type of priority. Suppose you want to go for the walk, and that's a priority because you have to maintain your health. So you are taking half an hour for the walk. So you need to give half an hour to that priority of going for the walk. So along with writing the priority, write the amount of the time that you are giving to each of those priorities, and then you need to minus all these priorities with the 24 hours that you have in your day. Suppose if you are having all the priorities set up for 12 hours in a day, then you're gonna minus 24, then you have a 12 hours in a day, then you can utilize that time. So if you are knowing that what the things really important to you for a day, and these are on your priority list, then you can save or can give the time more to the things that is on your priority list. So now let's move on to the second approach that I have for you. After maintaining the priority, you have the time wasters. You are doing the activities that are wasting your time, that doesn't really value you, that's not important to you. This could be anything like, suppose you are watching something nonsense on the TV. It might sound something weird, but yeah, if you're watching something, things on the TV that doesn't really value you, that doesn't value worth you, and you are wasting your time, you're giving your valuable time to those things and thinking, yeah, probably I would be doing something else. I have wasted 1 hour on the TV and it doesn't value me at all. So those are the time wasters. After writing the priority list, you need to write all the time wasters that you do in your day that kills your time, or that spend your time doing and wasting your time on those things. So you need to mention all those things also, and you need to calculate that. Suppose I'm giving 1 hour to the TV and I'm watching something useless, so 1 hour I'm wasting it. You need to calculate each of the time wasters along with their time, so you will be able to know how much your hours you are wasting in a day on doing the things that doesn't value to you, that are completely time wasters for you. And again guys, this is an individual stuff. Don't take it as like, so for somebody watching television is important because they are getting knowledge from it, and for some it would be a waste of time. So it depends on individual, your priority to watch the television because you're gaining knowledge, and it can be the time waster. So it depends on your list. I'm not talking about my list. I'm just generally telling all the tips that I think are gonna help you, because it helped me a lot. So before moving on to the another approach, I just need to say to you guys, if you're enjoying this video, give it a big thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, hit the bell icon so that whenever I post the more upcoming videos, you're gonna be first notified about it, because I'm gonna post more of this art related videos, and that really gonna help you in your day-to-day artist related journey. So now let's move on to the other approach that I have for you, is having a planner. I repeat all this thing again and again, but it's really important, so I usually repeat this thing. Maintaining a planner really gonna check on your time, because you are maintaining a planner, you are taking a casual schedule and maintaining that these things need to be done today, or these things need to be done on the weekly basis. And if you're doing it, you know that you are doing it. If you're not doing it, then you can calculate, okay, I'm not doing it, and why I'm not doing it, because these are the things that are wasting my time and I shouldn't be doing it. So maintaining a planner is a good deal, and it will really gonna help you in the long run. You need to take it guys in a long run. If you're thinking about the short term, then it's not being easy for you to get the results that you wanted. So always take it as a long term, because short term doesn't give the results that you really want it to. Stress more about the planner, because it's almost self-explanatory, and if you want more, then let me know in the comment section below. I'll make a separate video on that. And if you have any other art related problem or artist related problem related to your art journey, let me know in the comment section below. I'll make a separate video. video on that too, because I love helping people and yeah, I really love doing the what I'm doing it. So let's move on to the another approach that I have for you is reviews and feedback. Because if you're maintaining planner, you are focusing on your priorities and avoiding the time wasters, then you're gonna take out the positive feedback, because feedback is also essential. Because in always, whenever you are maintaining a business or anything, you have to have reviews about it, you have to have feedback, so that it will really gonna help you improving. Or it could be a positive feedback, it could be a negative feedback. If you're maintaining the planner, then you would be knowing about it, that how much you are wasting your time or how much you are utilizing and giving your time to what things that really matter to you. So in that way, maintaining a feedback and giving yourself the feedback really motivates you. If you are doing good, then you can motivate yourself. Yeah, congratulations, I'm doing good, I need to keep going forward on my journey, and that's it. Yeah, that's it. Really gonna help you if you're doing it good. And if you're not doing good, you're having the negative feedback, that's okay, that's completely fine. You can say to yourself, okay, completely fine, I'm getting negative feedback as I'm not doing the things I really have to do it. Okay, fine, I will going to take the steps to do more and to take me more forward to those things. So these are the four things I'm gonna help you in maintaining your time management. And if you need more help, let me know in the comment section below, guys. Till then, see the four more upcoming videos that are on this end screen, and see you for the next time, guys. Take care. Bye.